full semicircular canal. In the vestibule, you have here the vest, S, subcule, and utricule, and the cochlea. So, in other textbook, they call altogether the semicircular canal at the vestibule as the vestibular labyrinth, collectively. Okay, so if we start with this, we won't get lost. Okay, so let's review. Outer ear, pinna, then external auditory meatus. Middle ear, tympanic membrane, the meis, mancus, malleus, incus, stapes, and stapes is the smallest of the bone of the human body. And then after that, the inner ear. Okay, there's a window, the oval window. So don't forget that there's an oval window, there's a round window, but the oval window is more for going in of the sound, while the round window is also here. It is more for the ear to be spreading the sound somewhere there, but it's more of an exit thing. But later on, you will try to know that, huh? Okay, so then the inner ear is composed of that guy there, the oval window. Then, of course, this. You even expand further because it reminds you of the VST and company. VST, di ba? Awit ng pag-ibig, ay taba hangganan, di ba yung disco fever. So, VST, vestibule doc. Vestibule, semicircular canal doc. Yes. Cochlea doc. Yes. BSC and company. So the vestibule, where can you see the subcule and then the utricule? Vestibule doc. S. Subcule. Yes. Okay, huh? So things get better. Things have a better understanding. You get to enjoy. Who would not enjoy VST and company? Vestibule, subcule, okay, cochlea. Okay, so the external ear therefore consists of the auricle and the external acoustic meatus. The middle ear connects the external ear and the inner ear, of course. So when you hear a sound, the purpose actually of the external audit, the purpose of the pin, of course, because it tries to detect there about that sound, and then it tries to put the external acoustic meatus also, it goes inside the external acoustic meatus is like a funnel, but it's like a funnel, di ba? Funnel, ganun ang funnel, di ba? So it tries to direct the sound going there to the tympanic membrane, which is the starting point of the middle ear for most textbook. So it tries to vibrate there, and then it will transmit here through the meis, mancus, ilius, stapes. And then the stapes kasi is connected to the stapes, the smallest, or the stirrup. Is the stirrup or the stape is the smallest. It tries to connect with there with the oval window, and it also tries to vibrate there so that the sound comes here. So remember, in the inner ear, okay, the vestibule, and then the semicircular canal. So vestibule, diba? Vestibule. B, that is B, diba, doctor? So vestibule, the vestibule, B, is for balance. So always remember that the ear is not just for auditory, for hearing, but for balance. Huh? So vestibule balance, and the cochlea is the one for hearing. Cochlea, di ba? Cochlear nerve. No wonder you call the auditory nerve as the vestibulocochlear nerve, because it is for vestibule balance and at the same time for hearing. Okay. So when you talk about the cochlea, diba, it reminds you now of the wow, doc. It reminds me of the bony labyrinth. It reminds me that inside the bony labyrinth, doc, there is the perilymph. Yes, and then it reminds me of the membranous labyrinth, doc. with wherein there is duct, the ano, the endolymph inside them. Yes. Actually, all of them, this one, the semicircular, the vestibule, and then the cochlea, actually, they have this thing, perilymph and endolymph. Huh? Actually, things now getting easier because I am actually simplifying things. I also, ako, even as a professor, as a doctor, I try to simplify things. I don't want to complicate things because myself, if I try to complicate, I'll be the first victim, you will be the next victim. And remember, I am a professor. I want things to be understood by my students because that is my purpose. I don't want to be a sadist in which I would try to complicate things so that my students, when they exam, they would get zero. That's craziness, di ba? That's craziness, di ba, Ilani? Simply because, let's say, I'm a bright professor. I'm a bold placer, and I want to complicate things so that my students will get zero, and I'll be, when my students get zero, I'll be laughing and laughing and laughing. I'll be like a demon. Crazy. So I don't like that, because that's what we are for. This we are for students. I want my students to learn, diba? So that we can propagate all of these things to the next generation. That's the beauty of God. Okay. For me, but for others, they may disagree with me. It's all right. No problem, diba? Ilani, as long as where your heart is happy, you go for it, ba? Okay. So we go, huh? So the tympanic membrane is stretched across the external acoustic. Okay. External acoustic. Okay. The malleus, incus, and stapes. The malleus, incus, and stapes. Okay. So you are here now, the mist. So that's the middle ear. The mist, middle. When you say middle ear, mist, kaagad. So mist, Ilani, singko, koritana, mist. Malleus, incus, and stapes connect the tympanic membrane to the oval window of the inner ear. Oval, ha? Okay, there is also a round window, but later you will learn about that. The auditory tube connects the middle ear to the pharynx. So, auditory tube is what you call it also as the Eustachian tube. Huh? Eustachian tube connects the middle ear to the pharynx and equalizes pressure. Kasi you know what, doctor? Here it is. Diba? Outer ear, middle ear, and the inner ear. So, there is also a portion there in the middle ear which we call as Eustachian tube or the auditory tube, which connects to our pharynx. You know what, doctors, when we are above, when we are, let's say, for example, you were riding on a plane before the pandemic, diba? Before the pandemic, you go to Manila or to Cebu, you ride on a plane. But now, you hate to ride the plane, of course, because of the pandemic. It's a nightmare to be going to other places. So for you, it's a nightmare to go to Manila, especially, diba, that there's a great pandemia, diba? That's increasing up to 5,000. Then that this afternoon, diba? This afternoon, Ilani, diba? I don't want to hear the TB doctor because this afternoon, yesterday it was 6,000. This afternoon, docs, about 7,000. Then tomorrow, docs, 8,000. My God, it's a nightmare, diba? So let's really pray that the forecast, diba, that the forecast, diba, after 1 month, it will double by 16,000. My God, just, where is the future? Where is tomorrow? Diba, those news that are so bad. So let's pray for everyone's cooperation. Okay. So, you know, don't you know that when you go to the, when we ride a plane, so, diba, we are there in the plane here, Philippine Airlines. When we are up there, actually, the pressure inside the ear, the pressure inside our ear is increased. So that what happens, diba, when diba we have experienced that, Ilani and company, that we were up, diba, when it's about to ascend deep the plane. Or sometimes it's also, actually, just before it descends, and just before as it ascends, but more on ascension, it's painful, we have a pain there inside. It's because the pressure kasi inside the ear is increased. So what happens is that God gave this eustachian tube so that it can equalize the pressure. So from the increased pressure here, it can go out through the eustachian tube. So we chew a gum, diba, so that they can flow. It can equalize the pressure here. Or when we are also down here, we are also down. Usually, most of the time, the pressure outside of the ear is the pressure is low, then it can go to the eustachian tube and sort of like that. But that's the purpose actually of the eustachian tube. It's actually in your book. It's in your book in series. So the middle ear is connected to the mastoid air cells. No wonder that if you have a mastoiditis, remember, if you are observant, if you have a classmate before, if you studied in the SPED, you have a classmate who is deaf, or you know of someone who is deaf. Actually, the deafness was not congenital. They would say, why are you deaf? By writing they can understand your writing, man. Because when they were babies, they were not deaf. When they were very small, they were not deaf. They got just deaf because they had mastoiditis, infection of the mastoid. No wonder, because the middle ear is connected to the mastoid ear cells. So you can have deafness actually. And then no wonder also, diba, Dr. Ilan, in relation also to this one, in the inner ear, diba, in the inner ear we have the cochlea. Diba, the cochlea is one for cochlea is for, diba, cochlea is for hearing, diba. The cochlea, while the vestibule and then the semiral circular canal be for balance. Okay, so no wonder if you have a congenital deafness in which your cochlea is defective. No wonder the replacement for you to hear will be cochlear implant. Cochlear implant. Because the cochlea is the one for hearing. Okay, if that is congenital. Okay, So number three, the inner ear has three parts, the semicircular canals, the vestibule, be balanced, which contains the tuman, utricule, you, and saccule. And of course, the cochlea. Okay, so let's look at this one. The cochlea is a spiral-shaped canal within the temporal bone. The cochlea is divided into three compartments by the vestibular and basilar membrane. We will look at that later. So the cochlea is divided into compartments by the vestibular and basilar membrane. The scala vestibula and the scala tympani contain the perilymph. The cochlear ducts contain the endolymph and the spiral organ. And then the spiral organ consists of the inner hair cells and the outer hair cells which attach to the throat. So look at this one. Okay, so let's look at this one first before we continue. So we have the auricle. So we have the external acoustic meatus. Okay. Now, so we have here the tympanic membrane. So the malleus, incus, and stapes. So look at the stapes is, so we have here the window. We have here the oval. Look at this oval. It's for the sound to enter, oval. Then the round window. Usually the purpose is it exits the sound. So later on, I don't want you to forget about this because it happens to us. It happens to me. It happens to any person. after sick, if during the vacation, you tend to forget, where is the window? Where is the oval window? Let's not forget about the oval window and then the round window below, because through the window, di ba, ilaning in your background, you have a beautiful house in your background, di ba? You have windows there, windows, di ba? You try to look, you are in the middle here, you try to look through the window, you want to peep in the, you want to peep through the inner ear, through the window. Huh? Okay. So, and then through the window, you through the window, what did you see, Ilan, inside through the window in the inner ear? Look, I saw the snail. I saw the snail, the cochlea. It's like a snail, di ba? Then what still did you see? Ah, I see, Doc, that in the circus, Doc, I see also a circus. I see a circus. What circus? What do you mean? I see a semicircular canal. Diba? Semicircular canal, circle. I see a circus. I see a circus. But, and then in the circus, I saw there was a snail inside the circus. What else? Okay. Semicircular canal. Okay. Vestibule. Okay, so semicircular canal, vestibular nerve. Okay. Mo, this is Liane. Okay. And company. Ha, this is from one of my students also before. This is just a green joke. This is a green joke, of course. Green joke lang, ha. No one offends. Okay, just a joke. I was peeping kuno through the window. I was peeping down through a window. Through a window, what is the window? From I was in the middle ear. I was peeping through a window. I was peeping the inner ear. And you know what, kuno dok, what I saw? Vastus, kuno, vastus. Vestibule ba? Vastus. Can you connect? Vastus, dok, anak, nakita. Ano ka rin nakita? Ano daw yung nakita mo? Vastus na yan. I saw daw kuno akak. Akak, di ba, you know what akak is? Penis, di ba? Yes, okay, ang cock is a penis. Ano pa, kabastusan ang nakita mo? Okay. He associated the, yeah, di ba? Let's not make this a bastus anymore because we are naman medical students and we will be studying naman talaga about the reproductive organs. Di ba? We will be studying about the reproductive organs. So, this is the penis now. He associated the semicircular canal with the scrotum. Kumanoho, semicircular canal. So, Doc, vastus ano? Sabi ko, dito vastus, if it depends upon the context. Diba? It depends upon the context. If you will be using that semicircular canal, which you represent as the scrotum, and then the cup, which you represent as the penis, as a medical student, and as an educator, it would not be vastus. It would not be bastos. Anyway, if you try to put that into something else, X-rated, then it becomes bastos. It depends upon the situation. But no problem whether it be bastos. Do not do that bastos thing. Be an educator, be a doctor, and it will not be bastos. But what is important is that you associated the bastos with the vestibule, the scrotum with the semicircular canal, and the cochlea cup with the penis. There's no bastos in there. But we try to memorize things. It becomes easier. Okay? So, sige. Next. Okay, so, we go further, ha? This one, for the auditory function, I have also there videos here. I have videos actually here. So, let's just I have videos for the auditory function, for the neuronal pathway, simplified also for the balance. So, okay, let's just read anyway. So, pitch is determined by the frequency of sound waves and volume by the amplitude of sound waves. Now, okay. So, timbre is the resonance quality over tones of sound. You'll see that in the picture later on. Hearing involves the following. Okay, so when you say hearing, adoc, cochlear nerve, yes. Cochlea, balance, vestibule, and the semicircular canal. So, hearing involves the following. Sound waves are funneled, of course, by the auricle, diba? So, I told you kanina, down the pin and the auricle, diba? Pin and the auricle, down the external acoustic meatus, causing the tympanic membrane to vibrate. Okay, understood. The tympanic membrane vibrations are passed along the auditory ossicles. That is, the ossicles are the auditory ossicles are the mist, huh? Mancos ilius tapes to the oval window first, because that's the entrance of the inner ear, not the round, huh? Movement of, because the round is for exit, movement of the tapes in the oval window causes the perilymph, the vestibular membrane, and endolymph to vibrate. You will understand with this later on, with the picture later on more. Vestibular membrane, and endolymph to vibrate, producing the movement of the basilar membrane. Okay. So, we will focus on this later on. Doc, I'm confused about mga disong mga neural membrane. Sige, you will, later on. At least with this, you'll have no more problem, because we have already made a RAM on the other terms, like this one. Mga miss, okay, and aton cochlea, and vestibule, and vastus nga ni, vestibule, and semicircular canal, and cochlea, vastus kuno, vestibule. So it tries to narrow down things. Later on, you will understand more about this one, because you don't anymore have confusion for the memorizations. Then movement of the basilar membrane causes the bending of the stereocilia of inner hair cells in the spiral ganglion. Spiral organ or the organ of Corti. Anyway, so these are important terms. Sige, later on. Bending of the stereo plugs on the gating springs which open potassium channels. Potassium channels entering the hair cell result in the depolarization. So, potassium ions entering the hair cell result in depolarization of the cell. So, the depolarization caused the release of glutamate. Very important. Glutamate generating action potential in the sensory neuron associated with hair cells. The round window dissipates sound waves and protects the inner ear from pressure buildup. The round window, therefore, if the oval window is for entrance ba, the round window is for exit. Okay, so the round window dissipates sound waves and protects the inner ear from pressure buildup. It has to exit so that there will be no more, too much pressure of the sound. Huh? That's why the round window. Okay, before we proceed further, this is just in relation. I want to add this knowledge because this is very important. Okay, true. Okay, so I'll call on. Okay, I see there in my camera. So you just continue. I'll just be there in the camera, Ilani, because you will be one of the leaders also to take this minute. I see here, I don't know if it's connected. Sir Clint, my former nurse in Iberimsi. Sir Clint, are you there? Sir Clint, hello. Sir Clint, are you there? Or out of town? Hello? Is that connected? Anyway.
Hello, Doc.
Oh, hello, good morning. Sir Clint, how are you? Kumusta na ang aming nurse dati?
I'm good, Doc.
Okay lang? You're good. Okay, so tumataba na ba? Tumaba ka na ba? O dahil sa quarantine ka na ba? Quarantine? Anyway, so sige, could you please open your video, please? Okay, if you have a video.
Doc, mahina po kasi yun. Data lang po ako.
Oh, sige, no problem. Pero naririnig mo ako? Naririnig mo?
Yes po.
Okay, so sige. Okay, so in relation lamang, I want you to know this because this is very important. Because when you know what, you'll enjoy more when we are in radiographic anatomy. You will enjoy more in radiographic anatomy because my lessons are related to physio. So actually, diba, next week, I think I'm going to have another lecture, diba, to you all about physio, about GIT, about gastrointestinal tract. I'll be the lecturer. So we will be actually starting na our physio lecture integrated na with radiographic anatomy. So when we start with physiology about gastrointestinal radiology, I'll be starting with, we go immediately to abdomen, G84, the radiographic anatomy. So you will really learn a lot. Okay. Now, so, okay, all of you. So for Clint, okay. Dr. Clint. Okay, so answer. Give me glutamine is a neurotransmitter. It's a neurotransmitter. Tell me, is glutamate a pure excitatory or inhibitory? Inhibitory neurotransmitter. Excitatory or inhibitory? Sige lang. If you don't know, tapang lang. Tapang. Sige. Sige lang. So that you will learn. Excitatory, inhibitory. What is it? Or both? Sige daw, Sir Clint. Ano man? Hello?
Excitatory, Doc?
Yes. Okay. Correct. Pure. This is a pure. So always remember, glutamine, di ba glutamate, glutamate or glutamine, di ba glutamine, glutamine is like Ajinomoto, Betsin, you remember Betsin, di ba? You remember
yes,
that?
Doc.
So, whenever you put Betsin or Ajinomoto, it makes the food delicious, so you're excited to eat about the food. So, it's excitatory. Good. Okay, so next, glutamine. How about this one? Okay, Harry, remember about that, huh? How about GABA, gamma aminobutyric acid. Is it pure excitatory, pure inhibitory, or both?
Inhibitory, doc.
Pure? Or yes, correct. Pure inhibitory. Nagabaan ka, di ba, Clint? Nagabaan ka. Waray ka pa ngadto sa langit. Na-inhibit ka, inhibited, na-inhibit ka na mapunta sa langit. Ha? Okay. GABA. Na-inhibit ka, dahil sa kasalanan mo, nagabaan ka. Na-inhibit ka na mapunta sa langit. Okay, ha, GABA. Okay. Correct. Very good. How about this one? How about serotonin? How about serotonin? Is it pure inhibitory? Is it pure excitatory or both?
Both po.
Oh, very good. Very good. Okay. So, nasiro ka sa exam, di ba? Nasiro ka sa exam. So, na-inhibit ka na mapunta sa second year. Sample lang yan, ha? Na palagi kang nasisiro. So, na-inhibit ka, hindi ka nakapunta ng mid-2. Tapos, excited ka rin makita kung nasiro ka nga ba, di ba? Siro ba ako or nakapasa ba ako? So, you're excited to see. So, both, yan. Okay, very good, ha? How about this one, Doc? Sir Clint. Okay, this one. How about nitric oxide? How about nitric oxide? Is it pure excitatory or inhibitory?
Nitric oxide.
Oh.
Inhibitory.
Okay, no problem. Excitatory siya, pure excitatory kasi nitric oxide, di ba? Tawa ka ng tawa. Di ba? Di ba nitric oxide is a laughing gas? Di ba, Sir Clint? Di ba?
Okay, Doc.
You always excited. You want to laugh. So, excited ka palagi. Okay. How about this one, sir? Glycine. Is glycine a pure inhibitory or excitatory? Or
glycine.
Okay. Sige lang. Okay.
Excitatory din, Doc.
Dire, pure inhibitory siya. Okay, you have sinned against God. Okay, di ba, sir? You have sinned.
Okay.
You have sinned against God. Glycine, turn that into S-I-N. Okay.
Okay, Doc.
GABA, di ba? It's GABA, nagabaan ka. You have sinned against God. GABA, that's why you were inhibit going to that. And glycine din, Doc Sir Circlin, you have sinned against God. So, it's a pure inhibitory. This is very important, huh? Take note of this. Very important because you will be in our radiographic anatomy, because even though it's radiographic anatomy, I want you to explain the phenomenon through physiology. Okay, huh? So don't forget. So you have now collections of this little by little. GABA, nagabaan, inhibitory pure. Serotonin, nasiro ka, na-inhibit ka papunta ng second year. Or excited ka makita kung nasiro ka ba kay Dr. Paloma. Okay, so tapos nitric oxide is laughing gas excitatory. Glycine inhibition. So na-inhibit ka dahil because of your sin. So much for that. So, okay, so, sige. Thank you very much, Sir Clint. Ha? Okay, continue studying well.
Thank
okay.
you, Doc.
Welcome, welcome. Okay, so, I'll be happy to see you all actually in the second year, and I want to, after 5 years, I want to see you all coming back to IBRMC, my previous nurses, as doctors now. Let's pray for that. Let's pray for that. Okay, so, now, neuronal pathways for hearing. So, axons from the vestibulocochlear. That's why pala, Doc, ang auditory nerve is vestibulocochlear pala. Kaya vestibule, balance, cochlear po is
hearing.
Hearing, yes. Aside from the vestibulocochlear nerves, they synapse in the medulla, ha? Okay. So, neurons from the medulla project axons to the inferior colliculi. So, inferior colliculi is actually all about hearing. While superior colliculi is all about vision. Okay. So, for the pathway for vision, it goes to the superior colliculi while the inferior colliculi is for hearing. Okay. So, you cannot forget that because if it's the eye, diba, it's the eye, we have here the ear. Diba, usually ear, ear. So, the ear is inferior compared to that of the eyes. So, eyes is superior. So, superior colliculi, eyes, vision, inferior colliculi, both the ear. Okay, huh? So neurons from the medulla project to the inferior colliculi where they synapse. Neurons from this point project to the thalamus and synapse. Thalamic neuron extend to the auditory cortex. Huh? To the auditory cortex. Okay, so we go. Efferent neurons project to the cranial nerve nuclei. Responsible for controlling muscle dampened sound in the middle ear. Now, let's go. Balance. Static versus dynamic. Static balance. Oh, look, there's an eye. Static, there's an eye. Evaluate the position of the head relative to the gravity and detects linear acceleration and deceleration. So, static, I imagine this as eye. So, static, linear, deceleration, and acceleration. So, diba, if this is the gravity pulling us down, diba, okay, so you are there, static. So, therefore, linear deceleration and acceleration. So, the utricle and saccule in the inner ear, so vestibule, adok, ah, so vestibule, so saccule, and saccule, you, saccule, and utricle. So, they are in the vestibular labyrinth. Yes, okay, correct. So it reminds you also of the semicircular canal, vestibule, cochlea. Okay, ha? Huh? So gravity and detects linear acceleration and deceleration. So the utricle and saccule in the inner ear contain the macula. Ang utricle daw at saka saccule, di ba? Vestibule, yes. Saccule, utricle. Sa saccule and utricle, you, nandun daw ang macula. Macula. The macula consists of hair cells. So, when you say saccule, utricle, you, macula. Meron daw doon sa macula, meron daw doon mga hair cells embedded in the otolytic membrane consisting of gelatinous mass and crystals called the otoliths. Okay, otoliths. So, meron daw mga hair cells doon sa macula. Embedded doon sa otoliths. The otolytic membrane gives, therefore, moves in response na to gravity. Kaya pala, nagkakaroon ka ng static balance. Ang dynamic naman has 3 semicircular canals at right angles. Ganito ang ginawa ko para hindi ako mahirapan mag-memorize. Ang static, pag I, di ba? Linear, okay. Tapos, ang involved dyan is that because it has in relation to gravity, therefore, dapat matouch niya ang ating hair cells. Hair cells. Nasaan ang hair cells? Nasa macula. Kasi nagmemorize kasi ng subcule ng tuman ini man oh, pag static pa lang doctor tingnan niyo static pa lang static may S ka na subcule utricle macula. Meron sila sa macula ng subcule at utricle sa macula, meron doong hair cells na embedded sa yung O like okay, you looks that sounds like an O. U patigas, O malambot. UO met that na doon sa otolith ba embedded in an otolith medium. So may mga hair cells doon embedded in otolithic membrane consisting of a gelatinous mass na called otoliths. So, madurodali ma-memorize. Tapos, ang dynamic balance naman ay, okay, semicircular involved. Semicircular ba, diba? Semicircular, diba pag ganun? Semicircular. Para sang circus, diba sabi ko kanina, Ilani, circus, ang sayo naman ay kanina na pag-memorize doon sa inner ear, you peep through the oval window, masyado kang wholesome, diba? You saw a snail inside the circus. Di ba sa Ilani, ang circus, boring ba or dynamic?
Dynamic,
masaya. So dynamic balance. Dynamic balance, tricircular, the dynamic balance evaluates the movements of the head. So three semicircular canals at right angles to one another are present in the inner ear. The ampulla of its semicircular canal. Oh, look at this. May A na dyan, the semicircular. Nandiyan ang ampulla. May ampulla sa semicircular canal. The ampulla of its semicircular canal contains the crista ampullaris. Uy, ito nga si. Nganin si gamitan niyo ito. Semicircular canal. The ampulla of the semicircular ampulla of the semicircular contains the crista ampullaris. Which has hair cells with hairs embedded in a gelatinous mass, the cupula. Ito na liwat na si. Okay, kasi, so, Dok, kasi ganito kagawin nyo. Dok, I'm confused kung saan bang otolith na may hair cells? Saan ba, Dok, ang crista ampullaris? Kaya may hair cells man din yun. So, usually, nasa semicircular canal sila. Tapos, ang utricle and subcule in the inner ear contain the macula. So, pagdating dito sa static balance, sa vestibule, vestibule, may utricle, vestibule, diba utricle and subcule, meron dyang macula. The macula dyan, kung mayroong hair cells with hairs embedded in the otolithic membrane consisting of gelatinous mass called the called as otoliths. Okay, otoliths. Okay, otoliths yan. Okay, maraming problema kasi inuugdem mo nga otoliths, ha? May hair cells din sila. May hair cells din doon sa crista ampullaris. Isa na crista ampullaris, Doc. Sa semicircular canals. Di ba, no? Semicircular. Kaya maraming C dyan. Semicircular canals. May mga hair dyan. Cupula ang tawag dyan. Hair cells embedded in gelatinous mass, the cupula. Okay, so balance, vestibule. Okay, correct. Vestibule, may subcule, may utricle. Okay. Tapos, pag nagdaram ka, paulit-ulitin mo ito para nakaka-na-na-na-shape ko palagi. So, neuronal pathways for balance, axons of the macula and the crista ampullaris extend to the vestibular nucleus of the medulla. Fibers from the medulla run to the spinal cord, the cerebellum, cortex and nuclei that control the extrinsic eye muscles. Balance also depends on proprioception and visual input. So more on neuro anatomy na yan, ha? But anyway, ang akin lang na ma-connect nyo, ano bang mga parts sa ear bago mapunta yan sa brain, ma-register, ano ba? That's it. Diyan ang focus ko. Kasi yan ang area alam ko weakest. maraming nakukonfuse. So we go further into the picture. So all of us, let's now reflect. Okay. So, adok, pina, how recall. Okay. Papaspit ang sound. Padating dito po sa external auditory meatus, magiging parang panel siya, dinadirect niya po talaga doon. Yes. Tapos, ibibend niya ito. Itong tympanic membrane. Tapos, makukuha niya ng pressure dito. Mabibend sila dito. Kasi, nandiyan, sa mist. Tapos, sa stapes, katabi kasi niya ang oval window. So, you peep through the window and you see a circus, a snail. So, pag sabi mo circular, semicircular, dynamic yan. Ha? Okay. Vestibule, ventricle, saccule, oh, static po yan. Okay, static balance. Okay, very good. So, ganun yun. Ganun yun. So, it takes things easier. This is the approach that I made. Dr. Ilani and company. Ito ang approach na ginagamit ko ngayon. Nakaka-relate ka na ngayon kasi nagsimula tayo sa isang bagay na mapag-uusapan. Ngayon, mas. Ito ka na, Dr. Ilani. Narito ka sa middle ear. You're tripping through a window. Ang dami mo nang nakikita ngayon, maliban sa circus, nakikita mo na ngayon ang static balance, ang dynamic balance. You are enriched by the experience. Okay, so therefore, ito ay nabibend. Ito, pagka-bend dito, ito na. Parang yung mga, always remember na may mga fluid dito, may mga endolymph, may mga perilymph. Huh? So, yan. Sa movement ng perilymph, endolymph, dyan makikita mo. Na dyan, makakarinig ka na at the same time, makakabalance ka. Okay, ha? So, okay, let's reflect na. So, oval window, then, so, therefore, okay. Ano ang sabi dito sa ating, ano ang significance, doktora, dun sa book, Doktora Ilani, ng for the tympani? May relationship ba yan sa hearing at balance? Actually, wala, di ba? Dumaraan lang yan. So, ang for the tympani, ano yun, doktora, na sa book, na saan nag-display siya ng sensory sa anterior two-thirds ng tang, ano? Anterior two-thirds ng tang. So, pag nagkakaroon ka ng repair, nag-repair ka dito, baka kung mali ha, sige lang, anyway, nandyan, di ba, pag nire-repair mo ang ano, pag nag-repair ka ng ear, siguraduhin mo na hindi mo ito tamaan. Kaya pag natamaan mo yan, magkakaroon ka ng lost ng sensation ka ng anterior two-thirds. Diba, Doc? For the tympani. Tapos, ano pang usang structure dyan na nagkukunek, papunta ng pharynx, doktora, para tayo ay maka-equalize ng pressure? Eustachian tube or auditory tube. Ha? Okay. Eustachian tube, auditory tube or auditory tube to equalize the pressure. Okay. So, inner ear, oval with, okay, semicircular canals, vestibule, tapos cochlear nerve. So, kaya pala, vestibular nerve balance, cochlea for hearing. So, kaya pala merong vestibule, cochlear nerve. Okay, so we go. Ito na. So, incus, malleus, incus, stapes. So, inner ear, middle ear po ito, Doc. Okay. Nagkukunek siya doon sa mastoid air cells na ito. Mastoid air cells. So, pag, kaya pala, Doc, nagkaroon ka ng infection po, Doc, ano sa mastoid? Ng mastoiditis, infection. Na, kaya pala, Doc, ano, pwede kang mabingi? Pwede ka palang mabingi ba? Mabungol? Or you get death kay... You will be invading kasi these structures. Kawawa naman. So, kaya marami pala doon anong mga bingi na they were not congenital deafness. Actually, nakasakit sila sa mastoid. Kaya na-involve po ito. Kaya sila nabingi. Correct. Nabingi. Okay. So, tayo. Ito na. Ito ng isang pinangangambahan. Okay, madali kasi malimutan. Ako rin talaga noon, even ngayon, kung hindi ko talaga gagawa ng paraan, Mahihirapan tayo. Lahat tayo mahihirapan. Okay, so let's look at this. So, inner ear na tayo ha. Pakita mo pa lang ng snail. Pakita mo ng semicircular canal. Sabi nga ng estudyante ko, scrotum daw. Cochlea, penis. Vestibule, bastos ko no. Vestibule, bastos. Okay, sige, bahala ka. Basta ma-memorize mo. Okay ha. So, okay, dito na tayo. So, if you try to look at this, bony, sagaw labas, bony. Kaya tanatawin natin na bony labyrinth. Bony labyrinth kay bony. Pero alam niyo ba, nasa loob niya ay merong membranous o membrane ito. This one, membrane. Ito naman ay membrane. So, ang loob niyan sa membrane, membranous labyrinth, meron naman tayong bony labyrinth. Lahat yan, ma-vestibule, ma-semicircular canal, ma-cochlea, lahat yan, lalalain ito. Okay. Meron lang modification dito sa cochlea. Mamaya. So, bony labyrinth, doctors. So, sandali lang ha. Doktora Ilan, yan ang oras na. Baka nalilibang na naman tayo tapos hindi natin na mas dusin na.
11:41 na po, Dok.
11:41 na? Yes. Iba talaga ano, Doktora Ilan, pag nakakalibang, hindi natin yung oras. Kaya kung hindi ko ginadito, naku, natutulog na kayo. Mamaya wala na panisan na. Ha? Kasi kakalibang kasi. I cannot blame ourselves. We cannot blame. Okay, ho? So, anyway, may bukas pa naman. At saka, mag-review tayo, boys. Continue natin. No problem. Ha? So, bony labyrinth, ito naman ay membranous. Okay, ha? So therefore, ang loob nito, so look, this is a membrane, ito ay bony na. Membrane, sa loob kasi yan. So, yun o, dito, dula dito. Therefore, ito, membranous, di ba? Membranous, ito, two sides, membrane. Okay. From a membrane to a bone, yung nandyan sa loob na pic na yan ay periphery limb. Ito naman, purely sa loob talaga ng membranous, endolymph. Oha. Okay. So, actually, ang ate, ito. May mga fibrous bands pa. Very limp. Okay. So, very limp. Endolymph. Ganito yun. So, okay. So, sa cochlea naman, ito sa cochlea. Ang cochlea, ganito yon, nasa summary natin. Okay. Ito kasi ay magiging cochlear nerve ito. Okay. Now, the bony labyrinth in the temporal bone of the skull. The bony labyrinth in the temporal bone. Ito, bony labyrinth. Okay. Letter B. Okay. The bony labyrinth ito, yes. A ha, bony labyrinth. Tapos, yung letter B, the membranous labyrinth. The membranous labyrinth, okay lang yan, madali-madali ito. Tapos, cross-section through a semicircular canal to show the relationship between the bony and the membranous. So, membranous man ito, di ba? Ito, membranous. So, ito yun. Endolymph, ang inside. Pag dito ka naman sa bony labyrinth, perilymph. Bony man ito dito na portion. So, hindi masyadong mahirap yung maintindihan yan. Cross-section to the cochlea, ito ang medyo naku-confuse kayo. Cross-section to the cochlea to show the relation between the bony and membranous labyrinth. Actually, puro pareho rin naman talaga. Puro pareho lang. May modification lang kasi nakikita nyo ito. Nakikita nyo ito rito. So, ano ba talaga yan? So, dito, of course, bony. Tapos, ito naman, okay, huwag kalilimutan. Okay, sige, membranous. Kasi, actually, endolymph ito. May modification lang. So, let's look at the modification dito. Ito na yon. Nasa book nyo rin yan. Pamaya, pag tutukan nyo, ha? So, the inner ear. The outer ear's gray is the endostium lying in the intersurface above the bony labyrinth. Walang problema yan. Cross-section of the cochlea. Ito na. Cross-section of the outer layer. Dito tayo. Dito tayo mag-focus sa cochlea kasi dyan ang medyo na babaguhan kayo. A cross-section of the cochlea. The outer layer is the endostium. Outer layer. Ganun pa rin naman talaga. Lining the inner surface of the bony labyrinth. The membranous labyrinth pink is very small in the cochlea. Ito yun. Pareho lang naman talaga actually. Ito lang talaga may pinagkaiba. Yan. Nasa yan dyan. Okay. The membranous labyrinth is very small in the cochlea and consists of the vestibular and then the B and V. Okay. And consists of the V and V. Ang membranous labyrinth ay Di ba, you're so familiar, di ba, Dr. Eliani, with MTV? It is in your generation. MTV, di ba? Generation nyo yan, mga kanta, mga sayaw. Okay. Sa membranous labyrinth, sa cochlea, ay mayroong, i-counter mo doon ang vestibular membrane at saka basilar. Paano mo malilimutan ang basilar membrane kung ito, hindi man, basilar, kung ito ay baseline? Baseline, ito kami mga cells dyan. Oho. Ha? So, basilar. Therefore, yung taas, ano? Vestibular. Okay. Again, ang membranos ay may MTV. Vestibular membrane, basilar. Saan ang basilar? Ito po, Dok, dito kasi basal portion. Natural, okay na dyan yung mga cells. Ito naman ay vestibular. So, madali na mantindihan. Madali na memorize. So, the space between the... So, here. The outer layer is the endosteum. Dito sa... Dito tayo sa... Sa B. Ito na, dito tayo. Dito tayo sa B. A cross-section of the cochlea. The outer layer is the endosteum lining the inner surface of the bony labyrinth. Wala problema yan. The membranous, pink, is very small in the cochlea and consists of the vestibular and the basilar membranes. The space between the membranous, the space between the membranous and then the bony labyrinth consists of two parallel tunnels. Ito na. This one and this one. And that is the scala vestibuli and then the scala tympani. Okay, ha? So, scala vestibuli, scala tympani. So, letter C, you have here enlarged section of the cochlear duct showing the spiral ganglion. Spiral organ, ab corti. So, a greatly enlarged individual sensory hair cell. So, mga hair cells. So, okay. So, if you try to look at this, this the cochlear nerve, right? Okay. Ito na nakikita nyo ng mga cells doon sa basal portion na malapit sa basal membrane ay ang tinatawag nating spiral organ. So, ano ang component ng spiral organ? Spiral organ of Corti. Of Corti. Ha? Spiral organ of Corti. So, pag tinanong kayo, Dok, saan nakikita ang spiral organ of Corti? Sa cochlea. Ito manuho. Ha? Sa cochlea. Dok, ano pa nga? Dok, ano yung mga nandyan sa Corti? So, Dok, ano po yung nandyan sa corte? Ano itsura ng... Dok, ano mga nandyan? Ang corte ng cortex ay... Ang corte bang itsura ng corte ay may mga hair cells. Ganun. So, organ of corte, anong corte ng corte? May corte niya, mga ngayong hair cells. So, organ of corte, therefore, is composed of supporting cells. That's why they are there in the basal membrane underneath the outer hair cells and the inner hair cells. Okay. Importante yan. Because if you won't have that one, how can you hear? Diba? So, let's go further. Ito na. Sound waves strike the tympanic membrane. So, it's easier na to memorize. It's easier na this time. So, sound waves strike the tympanic membrane and cause it to vibrate. Okay. And vibration of the tympanic membrane causes the three bones of the middle ear, the malleus intersensitive, to vibrate. Natural. Vibration of the steps in the oval window causes the perilymph in the scala vestibuli to vibrate. O perilymph. Di ba alam mo na kung saan ang perilymph? Di ba? Sa bony labyrinth yun. Between the bony labyrinth and then the membranos. Di ba? Ayon ka kanina. Ito yun. Dito. Ito man, perilymph between the membranous and then the bony. Between the membranous and membranous, endolymph yun. Okay, so, vibration of the perilymph causes the vibration of the steps in the oval window causes the perilymph in the scala vestibuli to vibrate. Vibration of the perilymph now causes the vestibular membrane. Saan yung vestibular membrane? Adi man, Dok? Adi man? Kay basilara naman dila ka basal cells, di ba? It causes this one to vibrate. Okay. So, vibration of the perilymph causes the visceral limb to vibrate, which causes vibrations in the endolymph. Okay. Vibration of the endolymph causes the displacement, therefore, of the basilar membrane. So, pag nakita nyo ito, binabasa nyo ito, pag nag-review naman talaga kayo, tingnan nyo ito. Tingnan nyo ito kung saan sila, anong binabibrate dyan. Kasi mas isis. Nag-grab na kasi tayo dito, so it's easier for you. Ha? Okay. Which are attached to the basilar membrane. Vibration of the basilar membrane are transferred to the perilymph of the scala tympani. Vibrations in the perilymph of the scala tympani are transferred to the round window where they are dampened. Ito ang round window, di ba sabi natin exit ito. Para hindi masyadong mag-increase ang pressure. Okay, so ito na. Ito therefore, part ng macula, hair cells, support cells, macula, tapos vestibule, utricule, saccule. Okay, alala ko Dok. Static, dynamic. So, dynamic semicircular canals. Okay, static, vestibule, saccule. So, therefore, static saccule, utricule, may U, may macule, may hair cells po dyan. Okay. Tapos, sa macule, sa utulits. Very dangerous mass. Therefore, a dynamic, circular po. Semi-circus, like a circus, dynamic circus. Inner ear. So the ampulla of its semicircular canal contains the crista ampullaris C embedded in a gelatinous mass called the pupilla. Okay. So it makes sense na sa inyo. Okay, so therefore part of the macula, so when you say macula, naalala mo yung static balance, hair cell support cells. Okay. Okay, so this time you can relate. Imposible na. Kasi kanina natin, binamaster natin yung ramp para hindi sa pag-ramp. So, in an upright position, the otolith membrane does not move as the position of the head changes as when a person bends over gravity causes the otolith membrane to move. Ano rin yun sa, ano, sa summary. So, madali nyo na maintindihan yan. Pupula, crista ampullaris. Okay. So, anong oras na, Doktora?
11:53 na po, Dok.
Ah, pwede pa. Sige. Hindi. So, let's look daw. Okay. Okay, kita daw natin kung may bayad ba? Hindi naman madali lang naman itong mga ano. Madali lang naman itong video na ito. I don't know kung makuha ko pa agad. So, let's say, hello, naririnig nyo? Doktora?
Wala pa po, Dok.
Wala pa?
The human ear is made up of...
Okay, we hear the sound. I hear the sound.
Got the picture? Can you see the picture?
Pero I cannot see the video po. All I see is the download.
The outer ear consists of the pinna, which serves as protection for the delicate inner part.
Paano ba itong pinapandar?
I-stop share daw ni Doktor. Screen share and video miss me.
Stop muna, Anay. Ipopost ko. Ha?
Opo, i-pause Anay.
Katapos?
Tapos i-stop share. And then share again. Tapos ang video na miss me.
Agoy, lagas.
Sige, Dok. I-stop share, Anay.
Top shell anay. Stop share. Ah, ganito na lang lugod. Ah, ganito na lang, doktora, kaya pag alas 12 na. Ipapadala ko na lang yung videos na ito mamaya kay sin Doktora Cindy para makon sa group chat niyo. Tapos kayo na yung video. Ha? Mamaya, maganda kasi enhancement ito. It's all about a summary of the, but maikli lang naman, very simple. It's about a summary of the human ear, and then merong, tapos yung balance, how does balance happen through the ear going to the brain, and how do you hear also through the brain or through the ear to the brain. Yun lang naman, ha? Tapos papadala ko mamaya kay maganda, mas maganda. And then, 20 items daw ako, ha? Tell everyone, 20 items daw ako sa doktora. I'll be making the questions. And then, I'll be sending you also the reviewer mamaya. Ha? Para bukas, meron tayong parang question answer. Answeran nyo rin. Para mga pull-up questions yon. Pero from the pull-up questions there that is a reviewer, I'll get my questions there also. Ha? So siguro 30 points si Dr. Mambulaw, 20 points ako. Ha?
Yes.
So did I help you all, Dr. Ilani?
Yes, no.
Okay, very good. So thank you very much everyone, and we'll have a prayer first. In the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. So before I forget, 10 o'clock also tomorrow, ha, ang ating review. Huh? Review natin. I hope you get perfect, all of you. I don't mind if you get perfect as long as you studied. Huh? Mas maganda nga. Huh? Para naman lumaki pa yung score at saka yung kung medyo mababang grade nyo ng second, by monthly, ma-uplift yun. Huh? That's our target. Okay, so in the name of the Father, of the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Thank you, doctors. Thank you, Meduan.
Thank you, Doc.
Thank you, Doc.
Thank you, Doc.
Thank you, Doc.
Thank you, Doc. Adieu, well, see you tomorrow at 10 o'clock. Bye-bye for the review. Bye-bye.